Today we learn about the chemistry chapter, which is known as the Lewis structures of different molecules and ions. If you like this video, please subscribe my channel and press the bell icon. So what we have to remember for Lewis structure is Lewis dot structure, that is some basic concept of periodic table. So we know that in the modern version of periodic table there are 18 groups. So in these 18 groups we are taking only the groups from 14, 15, 16, 17 and 18. So the 18 group contains the helium, neon, argon and so on, whereas the 17 group contains, this is the halogen group, so it will be chlorine, bromine. After that, the 16 group is contained oxygen, then it will be nitrogen, and the 14th one will be carbon. And the group 1, that is contained the hydrogen. So another basic concept is that when we go from this 18 group to 14 or towards the group number 1, the electronegativity of the atom generally decreases. So that means that we know that the highest electronegative element is fluorine. So as we proceed from fluorine to oxygen to nitrogen and carbon, the electronegativity decreases. Similar thing happens when we go down from along the group, that is chlorine has the highest electronegative element, then the electronegativity of chlorine decreases and that of bromine also decreases from chlorine. So when a compound is formed between two non-metals, then the elements which has a less electronegativity should be taken as the central ion. The central atom will be the element which has less electronegativity compared to the other non-metal. So if you see a compound between, let us, nitrogen and hydrogen, or a compound between chlorine and fluorine, let it be ClF3. So then that case, which one will be the central atom? So the central atom will be the atom or the element which has less electronegativity. So among fluorine and chlorine has less electronegativity. So chlorine will be present as the central atom. If the compound or the ion is ClO3 minus, that is chlorate, then which one will be the central atom? It will be chlorine, because the electronegativity of E negativity of oxygen is greater than electronegativity of chlorine. So in case of chlorate, the central atom will be chlorine. So in both the cases, the central atom will be the chlorine. Now we try to draw a basic structure according to the Lewis dot. So here we take first, what are the steps? The step 1 is calculate the total number of valence electron. Calculate the total number of valence electron. First step. So let us try to draw the structure of a simple ions like SO2. So obviously the central atom will be the sulfur. So now in this case, what is the number of valence electron? So we know that sulfur belongs to the group 16. So it has a valence electron of 6. So sulfur has a valence electron as 6, and so that of oxygen also 6. So total number of electron will be 12 plus 6, that is 18. Now second step, place the central atom and place the other elements, the atoms, like in this case the oxygen in this way. And here we always take one thing you have to remember, that we see that we have to draw the Lewis structure of sulfur dioxide and it contains the 18 valence electrons. So first you put the central atom sulfur and the other two atoms, that is oxygen. Now here the bond pair of electron is denoted by a dash. Dash contains two electrons, because to create a bond we need two electrons. So that means that the two terminals contain two electrons. So that means first what you done, you just draw two bonded electron or bond between the central atom and with the terminal atom. Now these two bonds contain how many electrons? These two bond contain total number of 4 electrons. Each bond contain 2 electrons. So there are 4 electrons. So remaining how many electrons are there? There are 14 electrons. Now the remaining electrons should be placed on the terminal atom. And you always remember that if it is oxygen, so it cannot take more than 8 electrons, because they do not contain, the prior two do not contain any d orbital. So that's why they do not contain more than 8 electrons. But if it is sulfur, chlorine, they have a 3d orbital, so they may contain more than 8 electrons. So this is sulfur, this is 2 oxygen. Now we have to fulfill the octet, so we put 6 electrons here. So 2 plus 6, 8. The octet of oxygen is fulfilled. Similarly, here also we put 6 electrons. So the lone pair, you see that lone pair are denoted by dots. So now how many electrons we put total? Total we put 6 plus 6, 12 electrons. So 12 electrons are there. After fulfilling the octet of the terminal atom, if there is some valence electron left, then only that will be placed on the central atom. So how many electron left? There are 2 electron left. So that 2 electron will be put on the sulfur. So this is the primary step of drawing the Lewis dot structure. Now the second step, second or the third step, which is very important, you have to calculate the formal charge of each of these elements. Now the formula for formal charge is what? Formal charge formula will be number of valence electron, VE, just so we write it in a short note. So VE means number of valence electron minus the number of lone pair or the non-bonding electrons. Number of non-bonding electron, non-bonding electrons, and minus bonding electron divided by 2. So this is the formula for calculating the formal charge of an element inside a molecule. So for sulfur, first you have to find the what is the formal charge of sulfur. So what is the number of valence electron for sulfur? This is 6, as it is present in the group 16. Number of non-bonding electron we find. So number of non-bonding electron is 2. And what is the number of bonding electron? Bonding electron is 2 plus 2, 4. So that should be divided by 2. So it will give you how much? 6 minus 4, that is 2. Clear? So similarly you have to find the formal charge of oxygen. So sulfur possesses the formal charge of plus 2, and what will be that of oxygen? Oxygen also has 6. Number of non-bonding electron is also 6, and bonding electron is 2, because it contains only one bond. So it will be minus 1. So since these are similar, so each one of the sulfur contain minus one. Now the fourth step. Fourth step is you try to draw the structure in such a fashion that the central atom should contain the formal charge zero or as low as possible. So that can be done by giving these any one of the lone pair of oxygen that will be placed here. So that these two one lone pair, that is two electron, will form a bond between, and similarly these also form a bond. So that means the structure becomes S double bond O. Now try to find out the formal charge of sulfur. In the second step, after rearrangement of electron clouds, the formal charge of the sulfur will become how much? Same procedure, 6 minus 2. How many bonds are there? 4. So 4 means 8 electrons. So we 8 divided by 2. So that becomes the formal charge of sulfur, 0. And also try to find out that of oxygen, each oxygen are similar. So if you calculate one, that will give the value of other. So it will be how much? 6 minus 4 for lone electrons. And there are 2 bonds. So that means 4 electrons divided by 2. So it will be 0. So this will be the structure of sulfur dioxide. And it is predicted that it may be quite similar to carbon dioxide, linear, but actually in lone pair repulsion it will become angular. Thanking you that if you like my this type of video, please subscribe my channel.